People, during your lifetime, you meet a lot of people. Good, bad, wise, but when you work at customer service, you tend to meet a lot of off people. And what I mean by that is people who don't have all the components working in their brain. I've worked at two customer service jobs. My first job was Ronald McDonald, you know what I'm saying? Burger flipping, cashier tipping, food handling model McDonald. My second one, we'll save that. We'll save that for a later time. So my job at Ronald McDonald's was to get people's money, put it in the machine, give them the receipt, and occasionally I would take orders from the drive-thru. But my job is relatively easy, right? Right? Wrong. Wrong. Customers make it so hard for me to have an easy job. Like, it's really crazy. I feel like they just wake up and they just say, I'm gonna be a menace to society. Like, they make everything so much harder. Like, what encouraged you to do that? What encouraged you to ruin a 16-year-old boy's day who works at McDonald's? Like, that's crazy, bro. This one time, I was working at Ronald McDonald, you know what I'm saying? I was out there doing my little thing, you know, busting the orders, putting the things in the machine, taking the cash, doing the dash. I was killing it, straight killing it, having a great time doing my thing, doing the do. Boom, then this guy pulls up, and you know, he ordered like a sandwich, and some fries. Nothing too crazy, but it was like $3. Keep in mind, the whole order was like $3, right? I'm like, okay, total's gonna be $3.20. Before he gives me the cash, he hands me a coupon. And I look at the coupon, and I see that it's expired. That coupon is expired by like 2 years. What am I gonna do with that? So I tell him straight up, sir, the coupon is expired. He's like, no, coupon's not expired. It says right here that the coupon is expired. It says 2 years expired. And he looks at the coupon, and then he looks back at me, and he has the most, like, dumbfounded face, bro. Like, I caught you in a lie. I know you found this coupon on the side of your car seat. You were trying to use it to get a free burger, bro. Nah, that's not happening. This man's so persistent, bro. No, it's not expired. I came here yesterday. I got it from the manager. No. I knew he was capping. Right when he said that, I knew he was lying. No manager is gonna give you a 2-year-old coupon that's expired. Like, why? What is the purpose of giving that out? It's expired. It doesn't work anymore. Sir, I can't put the coupon in because it's expired. No. Put it in. I got it from the manager. I can't put it in. No. Put it in. And like, we're going back and forth. Like, he's saying put it in, and I'm saying it's expired. But I can't even put it in, even if I wanted to put it in, because it's expired. So the machine is gonna be like, nah. At this point, I'm ready to slide him, bro. I'm ready to get him that buy one get one free deal, bro. That buy one get one free deal. I'm ready. It's on sale. I'm ready. Yeah. I'm not even talking about burgers and fries. You know what I'm saying? But like, I'm heated. I'm ready to slap this man across his face. So we're going back and forth. We're going back and forth. We're arguing. Then finally, he says the famous words, "Let me see your manager." I'm like, oh. Okay. You want to see my manager? All right. But just don't be mad when you're looking stupid and the manager tells you the same thing that I told you. Saying? So I go get the manager, right? I go with the manager. My manager comes. He's like, what's the problem?
This worker right here, he won't put the coupon into the machine.
I was trying to give him that 1-2-1-2. Cause first of all, I can't even put the coupon in the machine. The machine will not allow me. So you're lying on my name right now. So my manager, he takes the coupon from him, right? He looks at the coupon. You can see in big bold letters that it's expired. 2 years expired. Expiration. Don't ask me how to spell that. My manager looks at the coupon and looks at the guy. And then he says, it's expired. Ooh, if you would have saw my face, like I was ready to
go to Marcus. Go to Marcus.
You know what I'm saying? Like I knew he was gonna say that. And you should have saw the guy's face. He had the stupidest face on his face. But guess what happened? Guess what happened? Even though the manager told him that it's expired and we can't put it in, guess what happened? This man starts arguing with the manager. Oh! This man's going back and forth. They arguing now.
No, you guys gave it to me yesterday because you made me wait in line.
No. It's expired, sir. I can't put it in. There's no way I can put it in the machine because it's expired 2 years. I don't know why we would give you a 2-year expiration. This is a drive-thru. So there's cars behind them trying to get their food. They're trying to feed their families. But this guy's holding up the line. So at this point, my manager is fed up. He's just done because this guy, he's not giving it. All right, you got it, chief. Goes ahead, did his little voodoo in the machine. Puts the coupon in. My manager leaves. He's like, ring him up. Like, finish ring him up. And he leaves. So it's just me and him. We're just standing there. It's just so awkward. I'm just looking at him. It's eyeballing. Yeah. I was ready to RKO him. I finally, like, I tell him, the total's gonna be 120. You're telling me, bro. This guy did all that. All that. For a $1.50 difference. He did all that for a free sandwich? Are you serious? A free sandwich? Now I'm not to judge. Cause maybe he didn't have enough money like that. Like maybe he wasn't fortunate enough, you know. And I respect it. I respect it. But you had to do all that for a sandwich? Wildin', bro. Wildin'. He ruined my rest of my day. Working at customer service, I have so many stories about people arguing with me or people just doing stupid stuff. I know this was not like something crazy, but it's just like, come on now. People just going crazy. And you know, there's other instances where customers are just being stubborn, just like him. A lot of times when I'm working at Ronald McDonald, the customer would not move from the drive-thru window because their food's not ready. Sometimes you mess up the order. You know, I'm a little clumsy. I'd be putting the McChickens with the mid, like, she didn't have a McChicken, but I'd be giving her the McChicken. That's besides the point. But, like, they just stay at the drive-thru. And even though their food's not ready, the person behind them's food might be ready. And oftentimes it is ready. So we just tell them to move up so then we can get that person out. And then when we get their food done, we just come out and give it to them. But most of the time, they just don't want to do that. And it's just me and the person who's in the car waiting for their food. We're just sitting there in silence. Sometimes they'll be like, is my food done yet? And I just, say that one more time. Say that one more time. I triple dog dare you. Is my food done yet? And I throw a cup of Sprite right to the noggin, bro. A cup of Sprite, because there's no way. There's no way you're doing all that, bro. I'm throwing a cup of Sprite in your head. I mean, McDonald's Sprite be tasting like jumper cables. Tasting like electricity bills. Like, what? What they put in McDonald's Sprite? There's so many instances where I almost got fired from McDonald's because these people just, they be testing you. They will test you. They will test you like this is a math quiz in algebra. I barely pass algebra. They be testing you. I would, I've seen a couple of baby weather fights in my day. So I know a little, you know, jab, jab, swing in my day. Woo. Call me Tiger Woods the way I be. What? This is just a little tidbit, a little taste. If you want to work at customer service, there's gonna be times when you want to give them that buy one get one free deal, and if you don't restrain yourself, it could really be bad. So you gotta really ask yourself, is this job really worth it?
Yo, it's your boy. Thank you for making it to the end of the video. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that thumbs up and hit that sub button. I didn't make an outro, so it's just a Barbie dancing. But you know, that's all right. That's all right. Stay tuned for next week's video. It's most definitely going to be better than this one. This one's kind of iffy, you know what I'm saying? So go ahead and hit that sub, and I'll holler at y'all later.